Now it's time for the AIU business session, wherein the dignitaries discuss about the important issues affecting us. For the same, I welcome Dr. Tej Pratap, who is the President AIU, Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General AIU, and Colonel Dr. G. Thiruvasagam, Vice President AIU. I request Dr. Tej Pratap and Dr. Pankaj Mittal to conduct the session.
Okay, thank you, Blessy. Unfortunately, Dr. Tej Pratap is not here. He had an urgent meeting with the governor, so he has gone there. So in his place, Dr. Thiruvasagam, who is the Vice President of AIU, will be chairing the session. And in this session, this is basically for all the esteemed Vice Chancellors. In the AIU business session, we tell the Vice Chancellors that what we have done in the previous year, and this year mostly has been the COVID year, but still whatever we have done, we'll share with the Vice Chancellors. And then also any issue, if the Vice Chancellors want us to take up with the government in any manner, if there are issues which they feel that we should sort of talk to the government about those issues with regard to the universities, based mostly academic issues, that we can do. So what I'll do is that first I'll give a small presentation of what we have done in the last year, and then we will request the esteemed Vice Chancellors to share their views and to sort of guide us if we how we can improve our working, and also if they want to take up some issues which they expect us to take up with the government. So we'll be ready to do that. So first I'll start with the presentation. I'll share the slides. Yes. Do I have the sharing slides?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you able to see the presentation? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
We are able to see.
Thank you. So I'll tell about the recent initiatives of AIU. First is the genesis. Many of the new members who have not been the members of AIU earlier, we'd like to tell you that AIU is a 95-year-old body, and it was established as the Inter-University Board on 23rd March 1925. And that is how now we have started celebrating 23rd March as the foundation day of AIU. So last year it was celebrated for the first time, but due to COVID, it had to be delayed a little, but then we did have the first Foundation Day lecture by Shri Kailash Satyarthiji, who is Nobel laureate. And then it was registered as a society of the Association of Indian Universities on 29th of September 1967. And the prestige can be known from the fact that the stalwarts like Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, Dr. Jakir Hussain, Dr. Mudaliar, who was also the education minister, Dr. Srimali, Dr. Shyamal Prasad Mukherjee, they have been the presidents of AIU in the past. This is the present membership of AIU. Out of about 1,000 universities, 822 universities are the members of AIU. These include 49 central universities, 348 state universities, 113 deemed universities, 249 private universities, 46 institutions of national importance, and 17 international. These are basically the functions and activities of the AIU: liaising and lobbying with the government, consultation and coordination, doing the capacity building of faculty, vice chancellors, and the leadership development. We do engage ourselves in a lot of research, publications, and information dissemination. We are also responsible for holding the cultural activities at the zonal, national, and international level for the university students, university and college students. And then we do also hold the, again, zonal, national, Asian level, and international events in the field of sports for the students of the universities and colleges. And one important mandate which has been given to AIU by the Government of India is equivalence of foreign degrees with the Indian degrees. So the AIU is the only organization in the country which is doing the equivalence of foreign degrees with the Indian degrees. So I'll tell you what new initiatives we have taken during the last year, in spite of this being a COVID year. One is that we try to improve the visibility of the AIU, like AIU website was redone, so that it is more user-friendly. And then AIU also had its media presence on various social media platforms like Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn. So regularly we are tweeting from the AIU handle. AIU flag has been redesigned. If you see at my back, this is the AIU flag, which has been redesigned. The renovation of AIU building is taking place. Just yesterday only the order has been given to the bidder. And now there will be very good conference facilities. I mean, within a year's time, very good conference facilities will be there in the AIU building. So if any of the university wants to hold their conferences or their meetings, like finance committee meetings, many times they have to hold. So AIU facilities will be available, including a good guest house. The guest house is also being redone. So a good guest house for staying and the conference facilities will be available to our member universities. Now we have also decided that after these zonal conferences, national conference will be held, but then clubbing it with the AIU Foundation Day, we have fixed the date 23rd to 25th March for every year to hold the national conference of AIU, the annual general body meeting of AIU, and also the Foundation Day lecture of AIU. I already shared with you that the first Foundation Day lecture was delivered by Shri Kailash Satyarthiji on 17th August 2020. These are the initiatives taken by AIU during the COVID-19 pandemic. We really felt that the teachers were struggling when the COVID struck and the universities and colleges were closed, that how to teach online, because our teachers, I mean, we can't blame them, but they were not prepared or they were not taught how to teach online. So we did hold many workshops to train the faculty on how to teach online. And we also had a program, I mean, online course was also available on the AIU website, that they can straight away go and do that course on learning how to teach online, Similarly for placement officers, because placement was an issue and many students were again struggling with the internship and placement offers. So for the placement officers, we did a program for how to do online placements and how to offer online internships, including sort of matchmaking of the qualifications of the student and the requirements of the industry, then holding the online interviews and getting the online letters. That was done. We did collaborate with National Digital Library of India for disseminating information about the large pool of resources they have with them. We also had an interactive session of vice chancellors with Sadhguru, who is very, very popular. And it was and the video message by the Honorable HRM was also played. AIU University News has been redesigned. Now, the way we have redesigned is that every month there will be different color and every year there will be different design, so that it doesn't become very, very monotonous. And during the COVID time, we did a digital copy of University News was there and e-copy was uploaded on the AIU website. Similarly, scholarly articles from eminent authors, that was released from AIU website regularly, and this was very, very popular. Like Dr. Sancheti's article was also there. Many eminent authors gave their article in this series, and all those articles were then clubbed and formed a book called Reimagining Indian Universities, which is under publication right now. It is with the publisher, so that is being done. And then we also held online 1 week course on community engagement and university social responsibility. So there's an organization called PRIA. So we collaborated with them and 1 week course on community engagement was done, because universities like corporate social responsibility, universities also have a social responsibility towards the community. So to take care of that, and the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan of Government of India is also talking about that. So we did a 1 week course, which was very well received. Just for a quick exchange of messages, we have created WhatsApp group of vice chancellors. Actually, the number increased so much that we had to bifurcate it into two groups. Now we have two groups of vice chancellors where we keep on posting information, and the vice chancellors also exchange their information. So if any of the vice chancellor is not in that group and they want to be in that group, please send a message to me. We will straight away include you in the WhatsApp group. But this is a very quick way of exchanging the information about what is happening in the universities and what is happening in the AIU and what initiatives AIU is taking. Then to promote internationalization, a concept paper has been passed in the Governing Council of AIU for establishing Indian network of international higher education. So it will be established soon. The concept paper is there, but this will be basically for the universities. For example, the government is trying to promote internationalization to a large extent, including in the NEP. A lot of modes have been given for promoting internationalization, but there are many universities who want to do internationalization, but they don't know how to go about it, whom to talk to, whom to collaborate with. So therefore, we are wanting to establish a network of international higher education so that there can be a lot of information sharing, and the universities who really want to promote internationalization, they can get a lot of guidance and help from each other. We also conducted a webinar on reshaping higher education. This was a webinar in which vice chancellors had conversation with Shri Ravi Shankar ji, and it was done in collaboration with Shri University. A self-paced free online course was also available on how to become a good online practitioner. This was developed in collaboration with Coursepair, and in addition to that, right now there is a collaboration between AIU and QuedEx. QuedEx is a platform which is promoted by Coursepair, in which many online courses on how to become an effective online teacher are there, and this is available on the AIU website. So any teacher who wants to get trained in that, so they can go and join that course. That not one course, there are something like 100 courses, and it is at very nominally priced program. So you can go there and watch that program. Similarly, on using various platforms like how to use TCS ION, Classroom or Microsoft Teams, we did hold demo sessions for our faculty members that how to use these platforms. Now it is becoming something very common, but in the beginning, when the pandemic just struck, they were struggling on how to use and which platform to use. So all this information was provided to them. And then these are the 5 conferences which we held. And luckily, all these 5 were held face-to-face. But at the time of national conference, it was not possible because that was in March. So that was held virtually. But these were the zonal conferences which were held last year. Annual meet was held instead of 23rd to 25th March because of COVID struck and there was a national lockdown. So it was held from 17th to 18th August. And the title was Reimagining Indian Universities. And with the same title, we have published a book with the scholarly articles from the eminent academicians. AIU Library, we have implemented the SOUL software so that all the books are now computerized. The soft copies of AIU daily news clippings, this is also liked by many vice chancellors, that any news relating to higher education, we are sharing with the vice chancellors on a daily basis. And every month, out of those clippings, we are forming a compendium of articles and editorials on higher education, and again it is being shared with the member universities. If any vice chancellor is not getting it, please send us a request. We will start sending it to you. And if you are getting it, and if you don't want to get it because it is sort of cluttering your email box, then also tell us, we will stop it. So we can start it or stop it based on your requirement. The bibliography is also being computerized in collaboration with InfliNet, and a QR code access is being given to the university so that you can read the abstract as well as the full text of the thesis through that quick QR code, in addition to having just the citation of the thesis. That is being done. AIU is now towards full computerization mission. So we are computerizing AIU. This is being done through InfliNet Ahmedabad, which is a government body and inter-university center of UGC. Every university has to register on the portal. Many universities have registered and they have got the login ID and password. If any of the university has not registered so far, please do it fast, because there will be many benefits which you will be getting through this portal, and you will get a lot of visibility also, because this portal is being accessed by many foreign universities, especially for the collaborations and all. So please log in, please register yourself on the portal, and please fill the information pertaining to your university. So the online payment gateway is also implemented. So if you want to give any fee to AIU for anything, I mean, whether it is equivalence fee or it is membership fee, and membership fee also, I would like to again appeal to all the vice chancellors, because AIU works on the membership fee. Please make sure that your membership dues are up to date. Otherwise, we won't be able to provide you these many services which we plan to provide. So we have very big plans for giving a lot more services to our member universities. So AIU admission portal is already on. AIU equivalence portal is on. Equivalence, we used to get a lot of complaints that this is being delayed, but now the application for equivalence is online, and the equivalence certificate can be downloaded online by the students. So there's no need to come to AIU at all. Payment can be done from the payment gateway, application can be sent online, and the equivalence certificate can be downloaded online by the student. So this is completely online right now. At present, AIU VC seniority list is being prepared. So please fill in your seniority details on the AIU portal, because if you send it by sort of say by email or maybe by hand or by post, so that will not go into the portal. But the portal information is what we will be capturing. So please fill up AIU VC seniority details on the portal. And AIU sports portal is also activated, in which all the students have to register on the portal for the sports activities, for participating in any of the sports activities which are taking place. And AIU membership portal, that is giving membership to the new universities, youth affairs portal, and collaboration portal is in pipeline. AIU collaboration portal, again, I will insist, will be very, very useful, because here what we are trying to give is that we are asking every university that what are your 5, 6, 7 best departments where you want to collaborate with the foreign universities. So when that information is there and the foreign universities want to collaborate with any Indian university, they will come to AIU portal and see at which are the universities which want to collaborate in a particular area. For example, environment science, if you want to collaborate. So they will put environment science on the AIU portal and they will know that which all Indian universities are good in environment science and they wish to collaborate, so they can straight away contact you. So this AIU collaboration portal will be very, very helpful exercise in promoting internationalization of higher education. So please fill in your details for the AIU collaboration portal also. In the long run, each and every service of AIU will be online. In internationalization, we have signed an MOU with NUS, which is the equivalent body of AIU in Mexico. And two universities have already signed MOU with two Mexican universities, one Jamia Hamdard at IFLU from Indian side, and there's one university from Mexico side. So they have already signed the MOU. We have also signed an MOU with UUKI to promote collaboration between Indian universities and UK universities. So if you want to collaborate with any UK universities, do contact us. We can get you in touch with the UUKI, who will tell us that which university in UK will be best suited for the area of collaboration you are looking forward to. We also did workshops in collaboration with World Bank and UNESCO, and a Taiwanese delegation also visited AIU again for collaboration purposes. This is with regard to research. We did many research roundtables of vice chancellors. One was on concept of eligible enrollment ratio, which is now gaining popularity, that something like 65% of the people who are eligible to get into higher education are getting into higher education, rather than 23% GER, which we are talking about. Then we also had roundtable of vice chancellors on emergence of STEM education, on philanthropy, and on world university rankings. These were the workshops which we held on safe campus, on responsible research and innovation, learning use of various online platforms, and global trends in international higher education. These were the online courses. Like I told you, online course on developing digital practitioner. Then this platform I was talking about, AIU QuedEx portal for professional development of faculty. In this portal, there are something like 100 courses. And for all those 100 courses, there is one fee, that is an annual fee, that is around $39 only. So in $39, the faculty can do 100 courses throughout the year. But this fee is for 1 year. Actually, the fee is around $99. But then the AIU sort of spoke to them and then negotiated. And then for Indian faculty, it is $39. So that those are very good courses. So I must recommend, I mean, if you can recommend to your faculty, they can go and attend those courses. Then we also had AIU in collaboration with PRIA, blended training program on fostering social responsibility, and a short-term course on safe campus. These are the research publications which we brought out. One was India Higher Education Profile, which was giving the state-wise education profile. I mean, you can compare various states also, and the vital statistics on higher education were provided in a graphical and pictorial manner. So easy to understand. The hard copy was sent to all the vice chancellors, and the soft copy is available on the AIU website. Book on Reimagining Indian Universities you will get very soon. Then there was a COVID response toolkit, in which we gave the step-by-step procedure for reopening the higher education institution. So this was developed in collaboration with Jindal Global University. So this toolkit is also very nice. A hard copy has been sent to all the universities, but a soft copy is also available on the AIU website. Then we also are printing a book on protecting academic interest of students during COVID. So whatever best practices were followed by various universities, they have shared those best practices with us, and we are compiling them to form a book so that the information sharing is there between various universities. And then we also conducted a survey on how much the Indian universities are prepared for online education. That is preparedness of Indian universities for online education. So that survey has already been conducted. The report is under preparation. And very soon the survey report will be there that how prepared the Indian higher education system is for the online education. So these are some of the glimpses of the research activities. In youth affairs, National Youth Festival was held in the MIT University during February 3 to 7, 2020. Then we also held SOUFEST, which is South Asian University Youth Festival, that was held in Kurukshetra, in which Dr. Sonal Mansingh, she also gave a performance. I mean, now in every festival, in international festival or in national festival, we are wanting to have an accomplished artist to come and give the performance. So last time Dr. Sonal Mansingh ji gave. We also held first AIU National Moot Court competition, which was held by Rajiv Gandhi National Law University, Patiala. AIU Youth Affairs policy has been formulated. It is on the website. So if some comments are there, you can give it. And then because the students were they were very bored during the corona because everything was closed. They could not interact with the fellow students. So we started a online cultural program called Kuch Artistic Corona. Corona and Corona were rhyming. So Kuch Artistic Corona, which saw a huge response, and about 600 institutions participated, and we got around 2400 entries, video entries of the performances of the students. These are some of the glimpses of the youth affairs activities. And then in sports, we are very happy to say that the first Khelo India University Games. So far, we have not held Khelo India University Games. The first Khelo India University Games were held last year in Keat University, Bhubaneswar, and it was inaugurated by Honorable Prime Minister of India. The Indian University's chess men and women teams participated in the first ever virtual World University and Asian University Chess Championship, organized by FISU. FISU is the World University Federation for Sports. And then World University Sports Federation has introduced first international e-sport football challenge, and AIU has fielded 3 players. So any of your players who are really good in youth affairs and sports, please do share the information with us, and we try to promote all of them at national and the international level. And next Khelo India University Games is scheduled to be held next year, 2022. For which zonals will be held this year. These are some of the glimpses of the sports activities. And equivalence of degrees, as I already informed you, equivalence is fully automated with features of downloadable equivalence certificate. The rules and policies for granting equivalence have also been simplified. Till now, we were depending upon the number of years, like if it is a 2-year master's, outside it should be 2 years. Because our master's is 2 years, so only 2 years will be given the equivalence. But now we are shifting to credit-based approach. If the credits are equal, we can give the equivalence. Similarly, for giving equivalence of PGDBM to MBA, earlier it was only NBA. Now 3 more international accreditations by AACSB, AMBA, and EQUIS, they are also considered at par with NBA. And mechanism is also being worked out to equate fellow program with PhD program. And more than 2,000 equivalent certificates were issued during the year 2019-20. So that's all from my side. Thank you very much. And
Madam Pankaj Mittal,
thank you.
Shall I share a few of my remarks?
Sure.
Yeah. Hello, participating Vice Chancellors. Hello, participating Vice Chancellors. Good afternoon to every one of you. I'm happy to speak with you all on the occasion of this conference. I would like to give my observation about the participation of Vice Chancellors in the forums like AAU. As you all well aware that this is the only forum available for the Vice Chancellors to place their grievances, request of academic or any other, and get it resolved. We don't have any other forum meant for Vice Chancellors. Of course, there are few organizations and committees meant for people of the management of deemed to be universities, even not for public university as well. So you have to take the maximum, you know, maximum interest in participating the activities of the AAU. I'm sorry to note that this is the second zonal conference we are going to complete today. The first one we had 10 days ago, that's the East Zone Conference. In both the conferences, I don't see the number of vice chancellors' participation is not that much good enough, number one. Number two, thanks to Dr. Pankaj Mittal, she arranged the top, at least middle level executives of the apex bodies of AACTE and NAC. We had advisors. The last conference, two advisors from NAC and AACTE, this conference also, they have given their address. I know pretty well. We have lot of grievances with these two organizations. All to be attended, all to be placed, all to be getting clarified. When the question of open session came, very rarely one or two vice chancellors raised the questions. So the purpose of calling those people and naming those session as interface session is not worked out very well, I am telling. Why you are hesitant to talk with them? Why you are hesitant to make use of the opportunity? Because it is very difficult to go to the NAC office in Bangalore. It is very difficult to meet the officials of UGC in person. It's the same case with the AACT also. Even if they think they cannot give time, because we are large in number, they cannot give appointment, you cannot see them and place your request. Even if you do it, it requires some follow-up as well. So it is my appeal to all the vice chancellors, have faith and confidence on AAU. And you can communicate to AAU, you can speak with the officials of AAU, and it, all, at least some of your problems and issues will be attended. At this juncture, I would like to make a request to Dr. Pankaj Mittal as well. The vice chancellor may ask a question. Madam, every year we go for several type of conference of vice chancellors. At the end of the conferences, we go for some recommendations. Okay, those recommendations, we take it very seriously and forward to the concerned bodies, affected bodies. Okay, how many of them taken care? How many of them have attended? What is the result given by them? That kind of action taken by those bodies also to be collected from them and shared to the vice chancellors. It is my understanding, it is one way only. They have not intimated. I don't know whether they have sent an acknowledgement even. It should not be the case. So when we and meet the officials, top officials, not the middle level officials, you are well experienced an executive and served several decades in UGC. You have very good rapport and very good even support even today as well. So these kind of things only help us to gain more confidence on the organizations like AAU. Hopefully we'll be doing in future as well. This is my opinion. And one more thing, as mentioned by Dr. Mittal, there are universities, they have several lakhs of amount as an arrear for annual subscription. Now, our past president, Dr. Sandeep Chansetti, is also with us. This AAU, we are running, we are functioning mainly out of the funds what we collect in the form of subscription only. The grant what we are getting from UGC or ministry is very, very limited. Now, slowly came down as well. So, as exhibited by Dr. Mittal, lot of good activities are going on in the area of research, in the area of sports, equalings, conferences. So many things are happening. And as said by her, we are actually remodeling or redesigning our building. And so many good developments are going on by developing international contact as well, for which fund is more important. All your funds, we take it with a transparent way and we spend it in an appropriate way as well. All the budgets, all the financial statements are being scrutinized by auditor, by auditors, and it is open, it is available in the portal also. You can have faith on us. So now it is my appeal to all the vice chancellors. See that you are remitting the annual subscription without fail. I'm sorry. I would like to take this opportunity to share this information, not to find fault with the vice chancellor or any university as well. These are all the remarks I wanted to share with you, my dear vice chancellors. If at all any question, both of us are prepared to answer. Please.
Just a comment from my side. Can I say something? Professor Thiruvasagam, can I share my views?
Yes, sir, please.
Okay. I think there is connectivity issue at his part. So, madam, I just wanted to compliment AIU, the president, the vice president, yourself, and everyone for a lot of good work, which you have reported lots of initiatives, e-initiatives, and lots of newness in terms of approach. And particularly, I'm very happy to know that you have started revamping not only higher education, but you have started revamping your building also. That's something very important because we needed that. It was in process, but it didn't happen. Some of us possibly are at fault for that. But I congratulate you for initiating that, and hopefully it will be completed soon. And also the Khelo India, the second version, I think should be publicized much more. The first one possibly happened at a short notice and participation or whatever, but this time we should come out with a target that how many universities should actually participate. If last time it was 200, let's say, my target this time would be putting it as a 300 or something like that. So work on that kind of a mission. We need a little bit more of the sporting culture and support for all these. So congratulations for all the good work, and convey it to Tej Pratap ji also.
Thank you. Professor Thiruvasagam, are you there? Any other participant, Vice Chancellor, if you want to share anything? Any suggestion which you want to give to AIU, or anything which you want us to take up with the government? You're welcome.
If no one is there, madam, let me raise that also. I think this development in regard to HECI would be something.
Sir, Sanjay Das like is speaking, and his mobile, his phone, his system is on mute. He is speaking.
Okay.
Can I say something, sir?
Yes, please go ahead, sir. Please, Varma sir, please go ahead.
We have one problem, ma'am, especially in the agriculture, School of Agriculture. There are two types of agriculture programs, one which are based in the agriculture universities, which have a different requirement, and then the agriculture programs, which are a part of the other programs of the university. They are sort of department in the university. The land requirement for both is almost same. It is 30 hectares. For a university where the agriculture is a department, to have a land of 30 hectares in the vicinity of the university is a very big task. And the agriculture program, as you know, as Professor Agarwal, Dr. Agarwal has said, is becoming very popular amongst the students. So you have to take up, can you take up this particular issue with the ICAR, that this requirement, they should look into as per the requirement of the program, whether it is a university or is it part of the university, is it more or less a department in the university, they should look into it, and they should allow the land to be worked with.
I will talk to Dr. Agarwal, but normally what he says is that because if you are running a program in agriculture, you need fields to grow the crop, because the students can learn only by growing the crop themselves.
That is particularly all right. But that much of land is not required once you are running a BSc program. So the requirement has to be different for a university and for a department.
We'll take it up.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. And then I must congratulate you for the excellent work you are doing it at the AIU.
Thank you.
Madam, the point I was trying to make was any developments regarding HECI that is not currently known in general, what role AIU is playing or what are the developments, if there are some things of that nature to share it.
So we actually don't know, but I mean, it is only a hearsay that the bill is going in the next session of the parliament, but we are not very sure about it. Actually speaking, when you were holding the last session on professional education, I was also wanting to know that when this HECI is made and AICT and NCT are merged in that, then who will be the professional standard setting body for the engineering and technology and management? Because AICT is not there anymore. So will there be two parts of AICT? One part will become PSSB and one will merge with the HECI. So actually there is a lot of confusion and not much clarity is there. Similarly for NCT, I mean, who will do the regulations for setting the standards for teacher education if NCT becomes HECI? So will HECI take it upon themselves, all these functions of regulating, engineering and teacher education, or they will be some other PSSBs for that? So actually speaking, nobody is clear on what's happening. So we are also waiting for the bill to come up, because with that bill, many things will be cleared.
So because that will set the tone for NEP implementation in right sense. So but
on our part, we are making an implementation document. That draft was that we prepared a draft in collaboration with Jindal Global University. And based on that draft, we are giving the concept papers in each of the five zonal conferences. So once it is debated upon, I mean, all that recommendations which are there, then we propose to bring out an implementation strategy from the side of the AIU, which we'll be presenting to the government, which will be giving for each and every recommendation of NEP, that what type of actions are required, who is the actor responsible for that action, and what should be the timeline, and what are the performance indicators, like how to measure whether that recommendation has been actually implemented or not. So we are working on that detailed document, which will be something like 150 to 200 pages document. So we are,
I think it's time that AIU can write that they would like to contribute to the establishment of HECI and all that also. That will be nice. Okay. We can write to the government on that. Yeah, please go ahead. I'm finished.
May I raise a question?
Yes, sure.
Yeah, I just wanted to understand that the NEP permits a four-year undergraduate program. Mm-hmm. So if a university wants to start it from the next academic year, this is the right time to start planning and to get it approved through the academic council. So does one have to wait for any other approval or any other UGC notification or something like that, or can one go ahead?
See, as far as I feel, once the NEP is out, many of the recommendations which lie on the part of the universities can be implemented. But then again, like for example, this multidisciplinary education. So this was being again raised in the last session. But what is the definition of multidisciplinary? How many faculties should be there to make it a multidisciplinary? How many programs should be there to make it multidisciplinary? For example, health education, people were asking that in health education, if there are different streams, or in agriculture education, if there are different streams like fisheries, this veterinary and all, will it make it a multidisciplinary, or everybody should have a social sciences, humanities, sciences, all the disciplines? So all this, I think the government has to make rules or some bring out regulations that what is a multidisciplinary university. Then only the universities will be able to decide what all we have to add. Of course, the universities can start adding randomly some subjects which they feel are useful for their university, but exact definition of multidisciplinary, how the four-year program will run, what type of courses should be there, would there be sort of some liberal education programs, or it can be all core courses related programs. I think that has to be decided at the central level. Then only the universities will be able to implement. But whatever you can implement, you can, but I cannot give a straight answer whether you can go for it or not, because the UGC has to take a call for it.
I'll try to give one different answer, madam, if I'm permitted. And that is, you know that ABC has circulated recently for your comments. And ABC is going to be an open framework, I would say. And under that, you can construct a new scheme, which can be by 4 years, 5 years also. And I'll possibly go to an extent of saying that Even a four-year scheme can become three-year if someone can be on fast track. Even that is possible. Dr. Pankaj Mittal is also there in that team where we have worked on all this thing. And basically, the news I get is that the ministry is keen to implement this scheme along with one more scheme from the ensuing academic year. So hopefully it will see the light of the day and give you all the controls in terms of time.
But sir, ABC is one route, but the other route which she is asking about, can we straight away implement four-year degree programs as a regular degree program? So that I'm not very sure. I mean, in my personally speaking, I would say yes, but then I'm not very sure with regard to UGC, whether they want to regulate four-year program by saying something.
Is UGC regulating BA, BCom right now as a three-year program? In terms of regulations, hardly anything. Some guidelines are there, I understand.
There are regulations for minimum standards of instructions for grant of first degree as well as for grant of master's degree. So there they have indicated what should be the minimum number of credits, what should be the minimum number of years.
That would be followed in 4 years automatically without any. This will be over and above 3 years only in terms of time, credits, everything.
Yeah, in fact, Section 22 defines the undergraduate program as minimum 3 years. So I think four should fit in quite easily.
But then that's when the Delhi University fiasco happened. That also,
I know, I recall that.
Times have changed, so let's say.
But that said, Symbiosis is running a four-year liberal arts program. Mm. And we've been doing it for the last several years.
Any other comments? You go for it and we'll follow you. That's all we can say.
Any other comment from any of the vice chancellors? Otherwise, we'll close this session and move on to the valedictory session. No? So, Dr. Shukla, I think we can move.